In this tutorial, I will show how to seamlessly combine data from multiple workbooks using Power Query. Power Query is the best way to merge data from multiple Excel files in a single file. You need to store all the files in a single folder and then use that folder to load data from those files into the Power Query editor. We have three workbooks in a folder for the employees' data for 2018, 2019, and 2020 years. If you have these workbooks in different folders, you need to move all of them into a single folder. Firstly, let's convert data from each worksheet into Excel table. To convert data in a table, select the cell and press Ctrl plus T. Let's give names for the tables. It's better to have names for your Excel tables, as it's more convenient to use when the tables are named. The data is structured the same way, with the same column names. Important to know before combining data. The worksheet names should be the same. This will help Power Query to go through your workbooks and combine the data from the worksheets that have the same name in each workbook. Power Query is case sensitive. This means a worksheet named data lowercase and data uppercase are considered different. To combine the data from these workbooks, go to the Data tab. In the Get and Transform group, click on the Get Data. Hover your cursor on from File and click on from Folder. In the Folder dialog box, click on Browse and locate the folder. In the dialog box that opens, click on the Combine button. Click on Combine and Load. In case you want to first edit the data before loading it into Excel, select Combine and Transform. In the Combine Files dialog box that opens, select the table in the left pane. Power Query shows you the table from the first file. This file would act as the template to combine other files. Power Query will use the column names in this template table to combine the data from other tables. If other tables have additional columns, those will be ignored. In case those other tables don't have a column, which is there in your template table, Power Query will just put null for it. The columns don't need to be in the same order as Power Query uses column headers to map columns. Click OK. This will load the final result combined data into your active worksheet. Power Query automatically adds the workbook name as the first column of the combined data. This helps in keeping track of what data came from which workbook. To edit the data, right mouse on the query in the workbook query pane and click Edit. Let's change the data type in the annual salary column. Right mouse click on the salary column and select Change Type. And choose Currency. Click Replace Current. Let's also delete the business unit and city columns. Select two columns, on the Home tab click Remove Columns. To load changed data, go to the File tab and click Close and Load. The real power of Power Query is that, when you add more files to the folder, you don't need to repeat any of these steps. All you need to do, to add the new workbook in the folder, refresh the query, and it will automatically combine the data from all the workbooks in that folder. For example, I add a new workbook for 2021 year data to the folder, and refresh the query, it will instantly give me the new combined dataset. Click on the query in the workbook query pane and click refresh. And new data was added. If you found this tutorial helpful, please subscribe to my YouTube channel.